Hello friends, welcome to Engineering Today, and we're back with some latest updates in this new episode. We'll begin with the latest update of Starship, followed by a contract which SpaceX got from the Italian Space Agency. We'll end today's space updates with Astronaut Wings presented to the Inspiration4 crew at SpaceX's headquarters. Let's start with our Starship update, where SpaceX takes some steps following its last successful cryogenic test. As we know how a small step for a man can become a giant leap for mankind, SpaceX's recent successful execution of Starship's cryogenic proof test is one such step. Starship stretched its wings last Saturday after its flaps were extended. This test might seem like a small achievement for now, but it still paves a way towards Starship's ultimate target, i.e. launch of Super Heavy. If the launch is successful, Starship's next attempt will be surviving a re-entry. This re-entry will expose it to extreme high temperatures. A lot of things might go wrong and every part needs to work perfectly so that Starship successfully gets through the test. If all the tests go as planned, the systems will undergo a free fall, engine reignition, a flip, and a landing maneuver. Starship has been recently provided with actuators, a pair of Model S batteries, and four large flaps. These flaps will prove to be an important part of the systems. These are not wings and meant for flapping motions, not to help in lifts. They'll help the vessel in controlling pitch and altitude and with rolling during freefall. The freefall trajectory and incapability of flaps in helping with lift leads to cross-range performance, which refers to the extent of Starship's travel after re-entry. This type of landing rules out the need for long and expensive runways. The flaps will also control vehicle orientation. They can operate on their full range during re-entry. Issues that can be faced due to overheated plasma are taken care of by introducing complex seals. Even after working mostly with steel instead of aluminum, Starship will have to face obstacles and mend parts after the re-entry. It's still unclear how SpaceX is actually planning to completely seal the flaps components. Starship's upcoming step in launching is reinstallation of the 3-6 Raptor engines before their static fire test campaign. The campaign is likely to begin as early as October 7th. SpaceX might start with 1-3 Raptors and perform some static fire tests, then move to the first ignition of the 4, 5, 6 engines respectively. If things go as planned, this event will be the first one where Raptor vacuum will be erupted on a Starship prototype. It will also mark the first time when SpaceX will ignite multiple types of Raptors on the same vehicle. In this case, the types are sea level and vacuum. Let's take a look at our next update, where SpaceX got a launch contract, which was earlier awarded to Arianespace. SpaceX is keeping up their champion aura over the global space industry. In the launch market of Europe, where Arianespace has a good dominance and near monopoly on European launches, a launch contract of Italian Earth observation satellite has almost jumped into SpaceX's hands, nearly swinging away from Arianespace. Within the last few years, Arianespace has become the topmost space agency in the European launch market. They mostly cajoled the politicians to compel the European Union member states to select specifically Ariane launchers for their domestic satellites and spacecraft. It seems that they've used their most time in monopolizing launch contracts rather than effective development of technology. Their technology development programs were also progressing in a sluggish way. Thus, though they got good subsidies from the European Union, yet they've failed in front of SpaceX's much more cost-effective and reliable Falcon rockets. Recently, SpaceX got the contract from the Italian Space Agency, ASI, to launch their Cosmo SkyMed CSG-2 Earth Observation Satellite on a Falcon 9 rocket. Arianespace had launched SkyMed CSG-1 in late 2019, and some reports say that the CSG-2 was also scheduled to launch on Arianespace's Vega C rocket in late 2021. But according to a recent report, the Italian Space Agency confirmed that they're shifting the launch vehicle of Cosmo SkyMed CSG-2 from Vega C to Falcon 9. In mid-2019 and late 2020, Arianespace faced two failures of their Vega C launcher, with only one success in the middle. These two close-by failures of Vega C launchers had raised questions on reliability of the vehicle, leading to delay in the Vega launch schedule by a long time. This triggered SpaceX's contract win. The agency stated, "The second Cosmos SkyMed second-generation satellite, CSG-2, was planned to be launched with Vega C within 2021, but the launcher development has been impacted by the VV-15 and VV-17 failures, and above all by the COVID pandemic. The delays, postponing the Vega C maiden flight to Q1 2022, with a consequent tight schedule of launches in 2022, made the launch period of CSG-2 no longer compatible with the needs of the Cosmo mission." ASI also said, "Since Ariane Space backlog was already full on Soyuz and Ariane systems in 2021, it was not possible to have a European backup solution compliant with the CSG-2 schedule. Thus, an alternative solution with the US provider, SpaceX, has been adopted, allowing to keep the CSG-2 launch within the current year." The SkyMed CSG-2, which SpaceX will now launch, is second in the row of four synthetic aperture radar satellites. This satellite weighs around 4,900 pounds. These satellites are specifically designed to monitor Earth from space, meter by meter, day and night, in any weather conditions, to help predict landslides and floods, coordinate relief efforts in case of earthquakes or fires, and check crisis areas. These satellites will mainly monitor over the region of the Mediterranean, but it will also cover up much of Earth's surface regularly. Though this launch is now on SpaceX's hand, it seems Ariane Space still has a chance to get a further contract from them. The agency stated they confirmed its trust in Ariane Space and Vega C capabilities by contracting the launch of the CSG-3 satellite planned for 2024. Moreover, other future launch opportunities for ASI missions with Vega C are under discussion, confirming Ariane Space as a key partner for the agency. Our last update is based on the Inspiration4 crew, who got their astronaut wings from the SpaceX headquarters. Nearly 3 weeks ago, SpaceX successfully completed their first all-civilian private crew mission in space. And now, on October 1st, Friday, SpaceX presented the four civilian astronauts, Jared Isaacman, Chris Sembroski, Haley Arsenault, and Shian Proctor, with astronaut wings at their headquarters in California. Haley Arsenault tweeted after receipt of astronaut wings, "Yesterday, we were presented with our SpaceX astronaut wings. This beautiful symbol of our journey means everything to me. Also, if it looks like I'm crying, mind your business." Shian Proctor said, "I cried when I got my wings." The Inspiration4 Twitter page commented that, "Our Inspiration4 crew visited SpaceX's headquarters in Hawthorne, California yesterday and were surprised with the SpaceX Dragon wings. Normally, commercial astronaut wings are awarded by the Federal Aviation Administration. In mid-2021, they announced that astronauts who have completed training and flight 80 kilometers above the Earth's surface and have also done activities during flight that were essential to public safety or major contributions to human spaceflight safety, then those astronauts are liable to be qualified for these wings. The regulatory agency also provides a memento wing to those persons who have extraordinary contributions to the spaceflight industry." According to a report, the astronaut wings presented by SpaceX were awarded to the private crew and given by the company itself. Report says that Virgin Galactic and Blue Origin also have such wings to award the astronauts. Sources said, "SpaceX's commercial astronaut wings are quite different from the FAA wings. There is a Crew Dragon capsule at the center from which wings emerge on two sides. Each crew member's name, their role in the mission, and their nicknames or call signs are inscribed at the back of the wing." Sembroski, Inspiration4's mission specialist, wrote on Twitter, "Until we meet again, thank you to all the amazing people at SpaceX who have done so much for me and Inspiration4. And most of all, thanks to my beautiful wife Erin, who gave so much to support this dream on a most incredible journey." The amount which Isaacman paid for the Inspiration4 mission is yet to be revealed. He stated, "It was great to see all our SpaceX friends and thank them for making this mission a success. Incredible memories." Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting. And kindly provide your valuable feedback in the comment section. This will help us to improve.